In this video, we'll have a head-to-head comparison of Labradoodles and Goldendoodles. Both dogs have their own charms that make them popular family companions. These designer dogs descended from the ever-intelligent and fashionista Poodle. However, Labradoodle is a mixture of a Poodle and a Labrador Retriever, while Goldendoodle is a combination of a Poodle and a Golden Retriever. If you're planning about welcoming one of these dogs but can't decide who to take home, then make sure to watch this video until the end. A doodle is a mixed breed that combines a poodle with another dog breed. And two of the most popular doodle breeds out there are the Labradoodle and the Goldendoodle. Although both of them came from poodles, they have significant differences that we'll talk about later on as we go through this video. Hey there, and welcome to Smart Dog Lover. If you're looking for a channel that features dog-related stuff every day, then you're on the right track. So make sure to subscribe to our channel. As mentioned at the beginning of this video, today we'll talk about the differences between a Labradoodle and a Goldendoodle. So let's get started right away. Size. First of all, let's talk about the physical differences between these two dog breeds. Both dogs can vary in size, since Poodle comes in three sizes, namely toy, miniature, and standard. First, let's talk about Goldendoodles. Standard Goldendoodles stand between 17 to 24 inches, or 43 to 61 centimeters tall, with a weight ranging from 50 to 90 pounds, or 22.7 to 40.8 kilograms. Meanwhile, miniature Goldendoodles have a height that ranges from 13 to 20 inches, or 33 to 51 centimeters, and a weight of 35 to 50 pounds, or 15.8 to 22.6 kilograms. Those who are mixed with toy poodles have an average height of 13 to 15 inches, or 33 to 38 centimeters, and a weight of no more than 20 pounds, or 9 kilograms. It does not differ very much when it comes to Labradoodles. Let's begin with the biggest variety first. Standard Labradoodles can grow up to 22 inches or 55.9 centimeters tall, with a weight of up to 60 pounds or 27.2 kilograms. The miniature variety, on the other hand, can weigh up to 40 pounds or 18.1 kilograms and a height of 20 inches or 50.8 centimeters tall. Lastly, the toy Labradoodle can grow from 14 to 16 inches, or 35.6 to 40.6 centimeters tall, and has a weight of around 15 to 20 pounds, or 6.8 to 9 kilograms. Temperament. Goldendoodles and Labradoodles are similar when it comes to their temperament. Both of these dogs are super friendly. Affectionate and playful, Goldendoodles and Labradoodles get along well with everyone in the household, including children and elders. It is also for this reason that they are used as therapy and guide dogs. However, because they are enthusiastic when meeting people, it also means that they make poor guard dogs. Instead of warding off strangers, they are most likely to invite them over for a cup of coffee. But if you're looking for a dog that can help you meet new people and expand your social life, then these dogs definitely make a great choice. Both dogs are also highly intelligent and are capable of picking up tricks and commands pretty easily. However, it is also for this reason that they need plenty of mental stimulation. This can be done by engaging them in canine sports or teaching them tricks and commands. At home, make sure to also provide them with a variety of toys that they can play with to keep them busy even when they're inside the house. Coat. Goldendoodles have a coat that can either be flat, straight, or wavy, depending on which parent's coat they inherit. Goldendoodles with straight and thick fur tend to shed more, which means that they aren't the best choice for allergy sufferers. On the other hand, the wavy or curly ones tend to be hypoallergenic, although you have to keep in mind that no dog is considered 100% hypoallergenic. On the other hand, Labradoodles have a coat that come in three varieties: hair-coated, wool-coated, and fleece-coated. Let's talk about those things one by one. Hair-coated varieties tend to resemble their Labrador Retriever parent more. They have a straight coat that sheds more, and they are also less common compared to other varieties. Meanwhile, the fleece-coated variety, also known as shaggy-coated, has wavy fur that sheds less. This variety is perhaps the most popular typical Labradoodle look. Meanwhile, wool-coated Labradoodles have thick, dense coat that is compared to a sheep's wool. These dogs are the least shedders among the three. Although you have to prepare for the grooming cost to keep their hair clean and free from mats. And we're already halfway through this video. So far, have you chosen between Labradoodle and Goldendoodle? Let us know your thoughts later on, because for now, we have a few more things to talk about these wonderful dogs. Who knows, you might change your mind after watching the whole video. So, let's continue. Grooming. To continue with the topic, let's talk about the grooming needs of these dogs. Since both dogs vary in coat texture, it is expected that they will have different grooming requirements. Let's talk first about Labradoodles. These dogs need to be brushed 2 or 3 times a week to prevent the formation of mats and tangles. Make sure to brush your puppy while he is still young, so he will get used to it. You may also give him regular trims to keep his fur looking clean. On the other hand, Goldendoodles need to be given a quick brushing every day to keep them looking their best. Some owners also opt to trim their coats for easier maintenance, so it will be really up to you. Remember, the longer the hair, the higher the tendency for their hair to get matted. A short cut of fur is recommended during summer to keep your dog comfortable. For both dogs, bathing should only be done when necessary, such as when they get really dirty. Don't bathe them too often, as it may cause their skin to dry up. Other grooming needs include brushing off their teeth as often as you can, trimming their nails once it gets too long, and checking their eyes, skin, and ears for redness, inflammation, or any other signs of infection. Energy. Again, both Labradoodles and Goldendoodles are similar when it comes to the level of energy. Since both are highly energetic dogs, they do best in a family with an active lifestyle. Without enough physical exercise, they can develop destructive behaviors to burn off their energies, such as excessive barking, chewing, and scratching of furniture, and they may even rummage through your garbage. So, unless you want to come home with a messy place or destroyed furniture, make sure that you are able to meet your dog's exercise needs. Training. As mentioned earlier, Labradors and Goldendoodles are highly intelligent dogs, which makes training sessions fairly easy. Aside from being smart, Labradoodles also have a strong desire to please their humans. If they see that you are pleased with their actions, they're most likely to do it again. However, their intelligence can be a double-edged sword, as they can also quickly pick up bad habits. Therefore, make sure that you redirect their intelligence to good behaviors only. The same thing goes with Goldendoodles. These dogs need an owner who can establish himself as the leader of the pack. If they don't see you as a strong and firm leader, they may take the role of the alpha. However, being firm does not mean that you should punish your dog. For both dog breeds, positive reinforcement techniques should be enforced to make training sessions more effective. This can be done by giving them treats, praise, and plenty of playtimes as a form of reward. And that wraps up our video about Labradoodles and Goldendoodles. We know you have your choice by now, but keep in mind that regardless of which of these two you'd like to keep in your home, make sure to meet your dog's needs in order for him to grow into a healthy, jolly, and well-behaved dog. Even if you have the calmest and friendliest dog breed out there, he couldn't be the best version of himself if you're not able to raise him well. We hope that we were able to help you a lot through this video. If you have anything to add or have questions, feel free to share them in the comment section down below. As always, if you enjoyed today's content, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. To be notified when we upload new videos, make sure to click the notification bell button. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.